बी रेडी, 5 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट. मिस्टर वाइस चेयरमैन सर, आई राइज टू लैंड सपोर्ट टू द रेजोल्यूशन मूव्ड बाय माय फ्रेंड विद फुल थ्रोटेड वॉइस. इट इज वेरी करेक्ट दैट द प्रेजेंट लीगल सिस्टम ऑफ इंडिया इज नॉट एन इफेक्टिव इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ सोशल चेंज. एज इट इज नॉट ए वेरी इफेक्टिव इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ सोशल चेंज, नेचुरली इट कैनॉट प्रोवाइड सोशियो इकोनॉमिक जस्टिस to the weaker sections of the people, to the underprivileged people who form the majority in India. Sir, we all know that the old order changes, yielding place to new. Change is the only unchanging thing in this constantly changing universe. It is not a very happy thing that although we attained independence in 1947, till today we are guided by Anglo-Saxon jurisprudence. We all know that India is a socialist country and goal of socialism has also been embedded in our constitution. Can you achieve this socialist goal through the present legal system? This is my question. I am sure none can give an affirmative answer. It is a very common complaint among the poor sections of the people of India, the downtrodden masses, the toiling masses, the people who cannot pay for costly litigation, that they are very scared of going to the court. First, they are ignorant. Then, they have no money. They are very poor. The court of law for them is a sort of jigsaw puzzle. Whenever they go to a court to fight out a case for the redressal of their grievances, they always have the psychological fear. What is the fear? What is the use of going to the court? If I go to the court for fight our a case, it will take 3 years to 10 years or maybe 20 years, who knows. So this inordinate delay in the dispensation of justice is a great hurdle for the poor people who cannot fight out costly cases. And even when they go to the court, the poorer sections of the people have to pay exorbitant fees to the lawyers. In the process, they lose all their property, lock, stock, and barrel, and whatever they already have. There is a very interesting story. Two people were fighting out a case in the court over land. They had been paying fees to the lawyers for a long time. If a man gets justice after 20 years, what is the use of this? Now, as far back as 1928, Pandit Motilal Nehru laid great emphasis on judicial reforms, and in the 50s also, of the chip, the old block, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru harped on the same string. Now, when people go to the court day after day, they have to wait, and why? Because some of the people do not know the actual procedures. Some people are afraid of going to the court, and poor people have got a sort of sentiment that these courts are made for the rich people, for the affluent sections of the society, for people with rest and fortune, and it is not meant for the poor. If we introduce this sort of judicial reforms by appointing a commission by which this sort of misgivings and apprehensions are utterly removed from the minds of the poor people of India, the earlier is done, the better it is for our country. Now, when we speak in terms of separation of powers of the executive, the legislature and the judiciary, all the pundits and all the scholars take part in this sort discussion and debates, and all of them lay great emphasis on the separation of the judiciary from the other two. There is a great reason behind it. It is very important to know that the judiciary must be kept separate from the executive and the legislature, but the judiciary must be free, not in words but in reality. The judiciary has got to be free. Now, our beloved Prime Minister has introduced the one new program. There are many schemes under this program, and I have found that under this one new program, lands have been distributed free to the landless people. But what happened the moment the Janata regime came? All the landlords came swooped on them and took away the lands, and those poor people did not get any justice anywhere. So, if justice remains just on paper, if justice is not carried into the field to the poor people of our country, what the value of this justice? I don't find any meaning in it. So, justice had got to be made effective, substantial and cheap, and its dispensation must be very, very fast. Now, I have gathered this knowledge that the National Law School of Bangalore has recommended that the law course should be for 5 years. I do not understand the reason behind it. 5 years is a very long time, and most of the poor parents cannot afford to defray the educational expenses of their sons and daughters who will have to pursue their studies for 5 long years.